Hello, welcome back to my Thoughtful Thursdays video channel, where we talk about important topics both inside and outside the church. As always, please make sure that you are subscribed below and turn on your notifications to see more videos like these in the future. Last week, I talked about Dave Chappelle and his irresponsible comments when it came to his latest Netflix special. One of the reasons his routine came under fire was his support of J.K. Rowling on transgender people. Dave Chappelle said that he was a trans-exclusionary radical feminist, that he backed J.K. Rowling in what she said, that she was essentially saying that sex is a real thing. He made it sound like it was just one little thing that she said that then was blown way out of proportion by transgender activists, that she was somehow unfairly being canceled. Dave sided with her on Team Turf, trans exclusionary. We have to take a look at what some of J.K. Rowling has said then to have a better picture of what is going on. It really starts with a woman in the UK named Maya Forstetter. Maya time and time again misgendered people. She constantly refused to use correct pronouns of other people. She said that women are adult females. She has repeatedly said that trans women are males. She has said that the idea that trans women are women is a literal delusion. You have to remember that in the UK, there is the Gender Recognition Act. Now, Maya went to court and just kept talking over and over again about how the law says that trans women are males, when in all actuality, the Gender Recognition Act actually says that trans women are female. She just got things wrong over and over and over again, and she really wanted to be able to misgender people, to be able to erase the identity of so many women. She said most of these things publicly via tweets or Slack. Now, she was reported by someone who took offense to her statements, and I believe rightfully so, and an investigation was opened. Rather than think about how her words might have been unnecessarily cruel to a group of people, she didn't apologize, and she didn't back down, because evidently we forgotten how to apologize in today's society. She doubled down. Forstetter states, and I quote, "I have been told that it is offensive to say trans women are men or that women mean adult female. However, since those statements are true, I will continue to say them." In other words, I know I'm causing pain to others. I recognize that I am offending people. I'm going to keep doing that. She was ruled against by a judge in 2019 after hearing everything that was told, after listening to Maya speak, after listening to testimony, after testimony, a judge found that Maya Forstetter was creating a hostile, degrading, humiliating, or offensive environment. Those are the judge's words, not mine. Judge James Taylor ruled that anti-trans or gender-critical views are not protected characteristics, added that such views are not worthy of respect in a democratic society, and that they conflict with the fundamental human rights of others. In his conclusion, the judge ruled that Ms. Forstetter was absolutist in her viewpoint and that she was unwilling to change her mind. He also said that she is not entitled to ignore the rights of a transgender person and the enormous pain that can be caused by misgendering. I think that the judge ruled correctly here. The instant that your free speech targets or harasses or creates an unsafe workplace for those around you, it is no longer free speech. I applaud Judge Taylor. I think it was the right thing to do. I feel the same about wedding cakes. If you can't make a wedding cake for a gay couple, I'm sorry, but you're in the wrong business. No gay couple should have to feel this enormous pain of planning for their big day to be turned down based upon their sexuality. That's absurd. Nobody should feel like they are less of a woman in the workplace because Maya Forstetter has to constantly voice her opinion over and over again. Remember from our vaccine video that we aren't rocks, we aren't islands. We work in a world with other human beings that are different than us. Well, J.K. Rowling made a tweet in support of Maya, and that is what Dave Chappelle was referring to. Now, is J.K. Rowling transphobic? I don't know. That is above my pay grade. I do know that she keeps doubling down. She keeps getting overly defensive and putting her foot into her mouth over and over again. I wish when people were called out, when people tell others about how their words are offensive, that they would learn to listen, that they would learn to allow themselves to be students and to be schooled by the pain that their words have caused other people. But they don't. Dave Chappelle gets called out for his irresponsible words, and he doesn't back down. He doesn't think or apologize. He gets defensive. Well, but my friend Daphne, or people when we start talking about race and racism in the United States, when they are called out for their racist words or their racist action, well, I have a black friend, or I saw Candace Owens talk. I don't feel like J.K. Rowling is listening to this massive and beautiful group of people that are just asking to survive. They are just asking to be treated as equals, to be able to live their lives, to be left alone, and to not be the butt of other people's jokes. or in J.K. Rowling's case, to not be one of the antagonists in a book. Rowling was under fire for having a character in her book, Troubled Blood, about a cisgendered man who dresses up in women's clothing to murder people. It goes back to this age-old fear that people have of never trust a man in a woman's dress. It perpetuates hurtful stereotypes in the transgender community, that transgender people are out to harm others, that they in some way want to be lurking in the opposite sex's bathroom, just waiting for their next victim, when obviously that is hogwash. Transgender people are almost always the victims of violent crimes committed against them, and they are not typically the perpetrators. Rowling has also falsely said that the rise of trans activism will somehow erase the concept of sex that defines the lives of many women, even though that can't be further from the truth. Once again, applauding others and wanting the best for others doesn't take anything away from me. I have a shirt that says it, and I believe that it is true. Equal rights for all does not mean fewer rights for you. It isn't pie. And I guess I think some people just don't believe that. Well, if we give these people rights and we support them and we love them or we want the best for them, that in somehow is taking something away from me. Supporting trans men and women does not take away from my being a man at all. How could it? Rowling has time and time again used fear tactics to prove her points rather than listening to actual voices who are speaking out against her. And I'll be honest, I'm disappointed time and time again with her response. She created a marvelous world that was the first taste of fantasy for many people, myself included. She has said in many ways that Hufflepuff was her favorite house. I'm a Hufflepuff. And if anything, J.K. Rowling helped to shape the minds of a generation of individuals who are now concerned with her statements. We love this fantasy world. We love the Harry Potter magic. We kind of just hate the things that she keeps saying. I don't want more of my money to go to her, if I'm honest, but I also don't want to cancel her. What do I want? I want her to act more like Mark Hamill when he got called out. After Rowling tweeted her support of Maya Forstater, Mark Hamill, who played Luke Skywalker in Star Wars, saw some of her lines and liked that particular tweet. One of Mark's fans called him out in a private message to him, basically saying, "Why would you do that?" And Mark private messaged back his fan and said, "I fully support my LGBT family. I had no idea the tweet had any negative connotations against them." But he didn't just remain private about it, he made a public statement as well. "Ignorance is no excuse, but I liked the tweet without understanding what the last line or hashtags meant," he said. "It was the first four lines I liked and didn't realize it had any transphobic connotation." That's how you do it, friends. When you learn, when you are called out, you think, you change, you grow, you evolve, you do better, you apologize. May J.K. Rowling be more like Mark Hamill. May we all be more like Mark Hamill. It really isn't that hard. In fact, let's just all say it together. Trans women are women. Trans men are men. There, that wasn't so bad, was it? After all, if Harry Potter has taught us anything, it is that nobody deserves to live in a closet. I know you can do better, J.K. Rowling. You have done harm to a community. They are reacting not out of canceling, but out of survival. Now, I have the privilege to write this and to shoot this video from the confines of my cisgenderness. I have the luxury to not have to think about this every day of my life. Others are not as fortunate as I am. For some, your flippant words mean their life will be much harder now. I ask that you would reconsider your words. I guarantee you that if you evolve and you grow in this area, your fans will be right there with you. Please think about that. Friends, that's all the time we have this week. Next week, I'm going to be taking a look at the opioid epidemic. You won't want to miss it. Join me back here next week. Same time, same place.